No, you are here, so you know it already. We have a half an hour. That is a nice opportunity. It's a great honor to share these applications with a beginner group, as it was told, but I'm not sure you are beginners. This is my intensive care unit at Hospital Ambroise Paré. From France to Belgium, this congress happened in a special historical phase of the world. We are doctors, so we try to fix patients, to save lives. This is our humble work. So we will try to do as best with the timing. It will be an appetizer in 30 minutes because it's a huge field. And we will try to show how and why a little less how, a lot why, but we try to be balanced because, as you can see, it's a huge field. Consider it as an appetizer, but with an appetizer can be more or less appetizing. As a medical intensivist, each time they wake me in the night, it is half of the time for a vital emergency. This is a lady with acute respiratory failure. In one word, we have no time for the clinic, but we hesitate between a bronchial or a cardiac asthma. We make echo, and this is the time where echo shows limitations. This poor lady has no cardiac window. Wow. The heart is hidden by these bloody lung parasites. And maybe some of you have recognized these comet tails that have the features of the B-lines, the lung rockets. They move. In one word, this is the B profile of the Blue Protocol. And instead of this ill-defined radiograph, we have a standardized lung ultrasound, lung rockets, lung sliding, called B profile, and with the priority diagnosis of hemodynamic pulmonary edema. It allows to change the therapy immediately, and the lady eventually had a hemodynamic edema. This is an example of the CSAMI protocol, that is cardiac arrest. A poor lady who had pneumonia, admitted in the ward, makes a cardiac arrest, a difficult one, and you know how blind you are for the sickest patients. This is why I never leave my ICU without my ultrasound machine. So just before the action, note that this machine is small. That is, I can go with that machine without displacing the objects. It is not a laptop. It is smaller than a laptop. Switch on time, 7 seconds, just time to take the probe. And one universal probe for the whole body. This is holistic ultrasound. Let's come back to the action. Cardiac arrest, the CSAMI protocol, begins by the lung, as you can see here. And the heart is considered in position number 5, cardiac arrest, heart number 5. So, are you ready? Top left lung, lung sliding, fine A-lines, right lung, top, oh, I see something that is not pleasant. I enlarge the image. And what we see is a perfect abolition of lung sliding. The patient is very standstill in cardiac arrest. And this is the M-mode demonstration of the abolition of lung sliding. We called it the stratosphere sign. The second point to see is that the pleural line is repeated here, that makes the A line. So we have the A prime profile in this cardiac arrest. That makes the diagnosis of pneumothorax really likely. Time permitting, we should have maybe at this area a vision of the lung point, that is a pathognomonic sign of pneumothorax. Allowing, once again, to treat quietly this gas tamponade. Here, so I update the images. This is an example of circulatory failure, a false protocol which will show a false responder. This young man took a lot of carbamate in the coma and in circulatory failure. We begin the false protocol. We can see that the carbamates are not the problem in this patient. So we make lung ultrasound. We see lung sliding and the repetition of the pleural line, which make the A profile. And A profile in this sequence is a clearance for fluid administration. The patient is full responder. We give fluid and the patient improved. That was a simple hypovolemic shock. In this hot, it was in 2003, summertime, very hot, so hypovolemic shock. Well, as Manu Malbrain said, it was considered as a foggy images by the experts of imaging, and it was a language, a genuine language that, for being deciphered, just needed a simple machine. Since 1982, the ADR 4000. At the SURF, our training center, not only we include the lung, but we also make it the most important target. Respiratory, circulatory applications, which means that maybe, I am cautious, if the manufacturers did not consider the lung, which is the first vital organ, please, maybe all of this is wrong, the machines that you have. They work, but maybe they can be optimized. We have seven principles for studying the lung. Here are they. We will see them quietly. First, the most the machine is old, simple, old technology without any facility, the most lung ultrasound will be easy. We have no nobology. We have just three buttons, no filter, no setting. The machine works ready for the SISAMI protocol. And when we do something different, like inserting a subclavian venous line, we do not change the settings. So they are always ready. In the lung, air and water are mixed. So I don't learn nothing to nobody. These are the rules of gravity. You will see pneumothorax upstairs and pleural effusion downstairs if the patient is supine. Let's go rapidly. The lung is the widest organ in the mammalians. And you will be concerned on where to apply the probe in such a large organ. And the SURF answered by using the blue points. Like they did for electrocardiogram, we have a technique allowing to make very standardized points, two anterior, one as posterior as possible. They have names. We will maybe see that at the workshop. Now we will see a little bit of ultrasound. All arises from the pleural line. That's the beginning of lung ultrasound. The soft tissues lung interface, and you can see the pleural line here that shapes a kind of a bat. No, don't you think so? Bat sign. C'est parti. By homage to this very smart animal that used ultrasound since the extinction of the dinosaurs. Very efficient animal. But let's not talk too much of bats. We are in a medical congress. The lung artifacts are of prime importance. The new machines would like to suppress the artifacts, so please beware. This is what we call the Merlin space. That is this space between the pleural line and the bottom of the screen, limited by the rib shadow. And we will give a name to all what is in the Merlin's space. Here we can see horizontal lines that arise from the plural line, and we call them A lines. For the first letter of the alphabet, they indicate, it is written here, they are equidistant from the skin plural line distance. And this is the pattern that we all have in this room, the normal pattern. That is the normal lung surface, which does not mean healthy lung, normal lung surface. Lung ultrasound is dynamic. And we will see again our Merlin space. And I present to you the latest definition of lung sliding. This is a homogeneous sparkling of the whole Merlin space. I put the video exactly this space beginning from the pleural line sparkles. Up to the end, when you make the M mode, this will make the seashore sign. You can see here waves upstairs, sand downstairs, and the pleural line is exactly corresponding to this difference. And we can use a very simple machine for that. We are at a beginner's course, but you are doctors and you must know the truth. Sometimes lung sliding is not so obvious, especially in sedated patients upstairs. Lung sliding can be very discreet, with not far from a stratosphere sign. And when you will see a very dyspneic patient scanned at near the basis, you will have a very hectic dynamic that sometimes can be a source of difficulties. This slide was just for telling you that you are doctors, not pupils. But how to decrease the difficulty is to have the simplest equipment. Look at this very important slide. You can see lung sliding in this image, and with some black magic, I will suppress lung sliding. Let us say it will appear again. Voilà, lung sliding, you can see it, and no lung sliding because somebody, me, pushed the button of averaging, making a soft image but not good for critical ultrasound. So beware, work only on natural image if you want to make a simpler discipline. And what is remarkable, I told you of the normal pattern, and it used only two signs, the A line, the lung sliding, making, if it is anterior, the A profile, which means that lung ultrasound is not completely ultrasound. That is echocardiography, obstetrics, that are very difficult, operator-dependent professions. Lung ultrasound is maybe, ironically, much more simple. Principle number 7 and last of lung ultrasound in the critically ill, all the acute life-threatening disorders touch the wall. Pneumothorax, interstitial syndrome, lung consolidation, pleural effusion. This is the image that you see here. No need to see the whole of the structure to know there is an emergency. The pathologic signs now. Pleural effusion. Rapidly, it is defined as an echoic. What is written? Anechoic. Ah, they define as an anechoic collection, but not at SURF, because this is an example of a pleural fluid taken in a. That's a fluid that you insonate, and you can see that fluids can be white, can be gray, can have plenty of echogenicity. So we don't use this color. We use rather a universal sign, which is the quad sign. The pleural line is here, and you see here a line which is parallel to the pleural line, which is regular, and this is the visceral pleura. We call it the lung line, and the visualization of this line makes a gold standard at the bedside. Additional sign is the sinusoid sign, that is inspiratory movement toward the pleural line that makes this kind of a sinusoid. Lung consolidation, we will try to do it in one slide, and maybe it is possible, time is running. When it is non-translobar, we can see this structural image with the opposite of a lung line, that is the fractal line, that is a line completely opposed, that is irregular, shredded, the boundary with the aerated lung, and the diagnosis makes 1 second to see that this is a lung consolidation. When it is translobar, it looks like a tissue, it looks like this spleen. Once again, we have a gold standard at the bedside. So we will not speak of the physiopathology of these signs, why we don't speak of subpleural consolidation, why we consider that a lung consolidation is not equivalent to pneumonia. We have plenty of things to say. The dynamic air bronchogram, the lung pulse, that's not for today. Interstitial syndrome, let us spend a few time on this. Interstitial syndrome is first the B line. First, the B line is a comet tail, which has begin from the pleural line, which moves with lung sliding, which has 4 other criteria. It is important to know all of them to be at ease with the patient. The B line is well defined. The B line is long up to the end of the screen. The B line erases the A lines that should be located exactly here at the standardized locations. And the B line is white, that is as echoic as the pleural line. With these 7 criteria, you will never be fooled by other artifacts that look like B lines but are not. What is interstitial syndrome? This is the number 3 or more of B lines between 2 ribs. Differently said, more than 2 B lines between 2 ribs is interstitial syndrome. And we call them lung rockets. I insist because lung rockets are the most important signs in all our protocols, blue protocol, false protocol. And we will see a little bit of these applications. So these are data showing that there is a correlation with what? With the second interlobular septa, or we will see the ground glass areas. And it is fully sensitive, fully specific. No disorder can simulate lung rockets if not interstitial syndrome. No normal lung can generate diffuse lung rockets. We will see that at the workshop. These are the interlobular septa, the ground glass areas. So we call them septal rockets, ground glass rockets, or GG rockets. It's easier to say. And both are interstitial. Okay, so let's spare time because we will be late. Pneumothorax, is it possible to do it in 2 slides? It should deserve 30 minutes. Let us try. At the anterior chest wall, we see a 100 sensitive side, which is not specific, that is the abolition of lung sliding. That makes the stratosphere side. And we see constantly A lines. Both make the A prime profile of the blue protocol. Now we see a sign that is completely specific, but not sensitive, that is the lunk point. That is, I see an A prime profile with abolition of length sliding with the A line, which are suddenly erased but by the respiration of what? Of, I would say, a B profile. There are some B lines coming. So A prime profile replaced by something else is a lunk point. And it indicates, according to where you find the lunk point, the volume of the pneumothorax. We will now see what we can do with the tent size that we evoked as an appetizer. We will see that these letters allow to make words, sentences. The blue protocol is a fast protocol. You can, yes, you can do that in 3 minutes or even far less than 3 minutes using lung and venous ultrasound. Which machine? We are glad to use the simplest machine, the most clean, the smallest, the fastest, most holistic in one word. If you don't have this Hitachi 405, if you have a laptop, you must optimize this laptop, you must optimize your approach to this laptop, and you will try to be happy with your laptop, even a US laptop. And I will go to the workshop and I will try to show that we can make ultrasound with even laptop machines. It will be more difficult, slightly or a lot, I still don't know, it's the surprise. I will try to keep quiet. This is the probe that we used for the lung, for the veins, and we've write all our books, including the last one, with only one probe, ranging from 0.6 to 17. Beware the US imitations, beware. Which is the probe of the intensivist, and we are not a small discipline, we are intensivist, and we can have our probe, I think so. Allowing a whole body scanning. And when you make lung plus vein plus simple heart, maybe you require less sophistications than the traditional echocardiographic expert approach. The blue protocol. This is the decision tree. These are the main diseases that you will see, that we saw in our emergency room of adult patients, all admitted to the ICU, so special patients. These data are obtained when you follow the rules of the blue protocol, that is associating signs with locations, anterior is not posterior, and usually associating two signs. 2 by 2. For instance, at the anterior chest wall, I see my pleural line. Here I see lung sliding. Here I see A line. This is the normal lung surface, that is the A profile. And if you use two signs that are lung sliding, lung rockets, you will see that they can be present-absent, present-present, absent-present, absent-absent. And each of these profiles leads to a specific disease. We will breathe, we will see it more slowly. Because I was a bit fast. To the left, we have lung sliding, no lung rockets, A line. We called it the A profile. The next patient that you will see with massive pulmonary embolism in the ER will have likely this profile. Just to the right, we have the same lung sliding, but here, lung rockets, B profile. And I bet that the next patient that you will see in the ER for a simple hemodynamic pulmonary edema will have very likely this profile, B profile. Here, you have the same lung rockets, but here, no lung sliding, two anomalies. When you will see a patient with that profile, I bet that this patient will have a pneumonia. And obviously, a patient with, so we called it the B prime profile. Obviously, a patient who has no lung sliding and no lung rockets has likely a pneumothorax to originate the respiratory failure. Again, the B line must be lung rockets. The lung rockets must be disseminated to the anterior chest wall, and they must be associated with lung sliding to deserve the label of B profile. And here things get simple. That is, we will scan this patient, dyspneic, he has lung sliding present. He has plenty of these lung rockets at the whole chest wall. That's the B profile, and the diagnosis of hemodynamic pulmonary edema is done with this nice sensitivity and a specificity that indicates that there is space for differential diagnosis. Beware, it's not 100. 20 seconds for the diagnosis, that's a really a fast protocol, and 20 years for having this microphone. Well, the opportunity to work with François Jardin, that is, I was at the best place for defining critical ultrasound. He was the first to have an echo machine for cardiac assessments. But when you have to fight against a medical dogma, you need 20 years minimum. I say it to the youngest, if you have nice ideas, be prepared and wait. And now we have an exploding family. That's a great, great thing. We are proud to have used the smallest technology before the advent of the laptops, with plenty of other advantages. Blue protocol, let's come back. To finish on time, it rules in, it rules out. If you wanted to exclude, for instance, a pneumothorax, you have lung sliding, you have lung rockets, it cannot be a massive pneumothorax. COPD or asthma put together for simplifying with interstitial signs, it cannot be usually, so we make one dotted line. And pulmonary embolism is, the B profile is seen in 4% of patients with native massive embolism, so two dotted lines. That is, sometimes it happens. So we will delete this slide for being on time. Pulmonary embolism, A profile plus deep venous thrombosis makes the diagnosis with nice sensitivity and a nice specificity. You can add your clinical judgment plus echocardiography. So to finish on time, what we have no time to speak is asthma, COPD, pneumonia, ARDS. False protocol, that is lung ultrasound for fluid administration in a circulatory failure. The CISABI protocol, that is lung, venous, and cardiac, of course, and abdominal ultrasound for cardiac arrest. That's a paper that Manu and I have just published a few days ago. Pink protocol for ARDS at the bedside. The Lucy-FLR project is for reducing drastically sometimes the irradiation, especially when you deal not with bariatric patients at the FAT protocol, but mainly when you have babies, neonates. The signs work the same. So let us use ultrasound. Voilà. So of course, I have, like everyone, a training center. Each time you make a profession where you have to assess the lung, you say the word lung, that is all the blue disciplines, you will find some place for lung ultrasound. And we will finish just on time by commenting this nice sentence that is still in the Harrison of 2015, please. Maybe it will be the last. I don't know. It depends maybe on you, if you can help us to enlarge these holes and give to this parasites, so to speak, a clinical meaning. Thank you very much for your kind attention.